the Church of St. Patrick. Please join us singing our entrance hymn, number 909, Immaculate Mary, hymn number 909.
Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and the Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you.
God, who by the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin prepared a worthy dwelling for your Son, grant, we pray, that as you preserved her from every stain by virtue of the death of your Son, which you foresaw, so through her intercession, we too may be cleansed and admitted to your presence. Your Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Genesis. After the man, Adam, had eaten of the tree, the Lord God called to the man and asked him, "Where are you?" He answered, "I heard you in the garden, but I was afraid, because I was naked, so I hid myself." Then he asked, "Who told you that you were naked? You have eaten then from the tree of which I have forbidden you to eat." The man replied, "The woman whom you put here with me, she gave me the fruit from the tree, and so I ate it." The Lord God then asked the woman, "Why did you do such a thing?" The woman answered, "The serpent tricked me into doing it, so I ate it." Then the Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, you shall be banned from all the animals and from all the wild creatures. On your belly you shall crawl, and dirt you shall eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. He will strike at your head, while you strike at his heel." The man called his wife Eve, because she became the mother of all the living. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
brothers and sisters, blessed be the God of earth and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavens, as he chose us in him before the foundation of the world, to be holy and without blemish before him. In love he destined us for adoption to himself through Jesus Christ, in accordance with the favor of his will, for the praise of the glory of his grace, that he be granted us and the beloved. In him we are also chosen, destined in accord with the purpose of the one who accomplishes all things according to the intention of his will, so that we might exist for the praise of his glory, we who first hoped in Christ. The word of the Lord.
Very happy to welcome our students here to this special Mass tonight. Mass, one of the solemnities of the year, one of the holy days of obligation. So on this special day, the special Mass, we have you here for a little ceremony as well, called the inscription ceremony. Basically, it's telling our church that you are the next one to receive the sacrament of reconciliation, first Holy Communion, and some of you, confirmation. These sacraments will take place this springtime, with confirmation in April. And so, this is a special Mass where you're letting the parish know you're getting ready. You're getting ready to receive these sacraments. And it's also for us to hear from you that you really want these sacraments and desire them to grow in holiness. Tonight we celebrate the beautiful feast of the Blessed Mother, her Immaculate Conception. We see this beautiful statue up here in our sanctuary of Mary holding the Christ child. That certainly could be the day after Christmas. The child was born. And as we're getting ready for the feast of Christmas, getting our homes ready for Christmas, this feast is about God getting Mary ready for Christmas. He prepared her. Our readings today have a great contrast with Eve from the Old Testament, Mary in the New Testament. God had a beautiful plan, a beautiful garden in paradise planned out for Adam and Eve. But Eve was disobedient, and that plan fell through. God gives us a free will. He doesn't force us. He invites us. He invites us to turn our heart towards Him. So while Eve disobeyed, and she kind of did not accept God's plan, in contrast, Mary, the mother of God, says, yes, I will be the mother of God. God had a plan for her, and she says yes to that plan. And as we can only imagine, for the first Christmas, for God to come down among us, we need a mother. And so in God's plan, Mary is prepared from the moment of her birth, from the moment of her conception. She is prepared to be the mother of God. She would be the sinless virgin who will give us Jesus. As we look on the statue, this beautiful statue and countenance of the Blessed Mother, we see her willingness to say, yes, I accept this child, I accept God in my life. I want to serve Him. So she gives her beautiful yes to be the mother of God. Boys and girls, God was with her from the beginning of her existence. And God is with each of you from the beginning of your existence through the sacrament of baptism. Jesus is with you. And as God had a special plan for Mary, God has a special plan for each one of you as well. And that plan is to be the best person you can right now at your age. Be the best student. Be the best son or daughter that you possibly can. That's God's invitation planned for you now. He will have bigger plans for you as you grow older. How can you be ready for those big plans? By saying yes to God now. And saying, yes, Lord, I want to be your friend. Yes, Lord, I want to imitate you. I want to help other people who are in need. In this way, we begin to prepare ourselves for the big plans that God has in store. As we celebrate tonight, we come to the altar to receive Holy Communion. Holy Communion is that Jesus pledged to be with us always. And so as we receive the Holy Eucharist, and some of you will pray for the day you will receive your first Holy Communion, may God bless each one of us as we get ready for the Feast of Christmas by being kind towards one another. This time now, we will ask God's special blessing upon the young people of our parish. Will the candidates receiving the sacraments of reconciliation, Holy Eucharist, and confirmation please stand? In response to the invitation of this parish community, I hereby ask you to declare your intention to prepare for the sacrament that you will receive. Do you intend to ready yourself over these months to receive the gifts of the sacrament of reconciliation, Holy Eucharist, and confirmation by assisting at Mass prayerfully and faithfully? If so, say, yes, we do.
Yes, we do.
Do you intend to study and to come to know your own special gifts of God, which you can give to your family, your community, and your church?
Yes, we do.
Do you intend to put your talents to work for others? Serve them when you see someone in need.
Yes, we do.
In the name of the Church of St. Patrick, I accept your inscription promises. I hereby recognize you as a candidate for the sacraments of reconciliation, Holy Eucharist, and confirmation. I ask the parish community to join me in prayer for you in the coming months as you prepare to more fully enter into the life of the Church. The candidates will bring their signed inscription promise sheets up to the priest and place them in the basket provided. You may then return to your seats. Please stand. Prayerfully now, let us proclaim our profession of faith. I believe in one God,
Father Almighty, and Maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible.
Bring our petitions to the Lord, trusting that His plan will bring us to the fullness of life.
For bishops, priests, and religious, may God strengthen them in faith and bless their ministry. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For public authorities, may God strengthen them in serving with integrity and protecting all life from conception to natural death. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
families who lack adequate shelter, may the Lord in His great mercy grant them all their needs. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our faith community, may the the Holy Spirit help us grow in holiness during this holy season of preparation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for our beloved dead, may Jesus welcome them into his heavenly kingdom to rejoice forever with our blessed mother and all the saints and angels. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for Jacqueline Mitchell, whom this Mass is being offered this evening, that she may always share in eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
and for all those petitions we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Gracious God, hear the prayers we bring before you this day, for we ask all these prayers through Christ our Lord.
Please join in singing our preparation hymn number 352, O Come Divine Messiah, hymn number 352.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice and yours.
graciously accept the saving sacrifice by which we offer you, O Lord, on the solemnity of the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary, and grant that, as we profess her on account of our prevenient grace, to be untouched by any stain of sin, so through her intercession we may be delivered from all our faults, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you preserve the most blessed Virgin Mary from all stain of original sin, so that in her, endowed with the rich fullness of your grace, you might prepare a worthy mother for your Son, and signify the beginning of the Church, his beautiful bride, without spot or wrinkle. She, the most pure virgin, was to bring forth a Son, the innocent Lamb, who would wipe away our offenses. You place her above all others, to be for your people an advocate of grace and a model of holiness. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Thank you.
offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Alfred, our Bishop, and all the clergy, the men and women who consecrated life, and the people of God. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, your spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who please you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called for the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, have mercy.
Thank you. Let us pray. May the sacrament we have received, O Lord our God, heal in us the wounds of that fall, from which in a singular way we preserve Blessed Mary in her immaculate conception, through Christ our Lord. Just one announcement, and that's an invitation for everyone to join us out on the sidewalk as we sing some Christmas carols and turn the lights on our big tree. I don't know, it looks a lot bigger than last year. I think you're going to be able to see this tree from Hazel. So please join us out on the sidewalks, immediately after Mass, the lighting of our Christmas tree on the building, and then in honor of our students, we'll have hot chocolate and cookies in the hall for everybody. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is ended. Let us walk again.